Good morning to all my dear students. I welcome you in the class of English Text Standard 9. Today we will do poem 8, that is On Killing a Tree, written by G.V. Patel. About the poet. This poem is written by G.V. Patel. He lives in Mumbai and practices medicine. He writes poems and plays in English. His poems appeared in the Illustrated Weekly of India. Introduction to the poem. This is the best known poem by G.V. Patel. The poet compares the trees to human beings. According to him, trees also have the right to live like any other creature in the world. But he is painted to see that it is the human being only who kills the trees without any of the intention, and he kills the trees with utmost cruelty. The poet has all sympathy for the trees. You must have observed people cutting down trees, but can you imagine that they can even kill a tree? Let's see what the poet says on killing a tree. It takes much time to kill a tree. Not a simple jab of the knife will do it. It has grown, slowly consuming the earth, rising out of it, feeding upon its crust, absorbing years of sunlight, air, water, and out of its leprous hide, sprouting leaves. Now, through these lines, through the first stanza, the poet wants to say that in order to kill a tree, it has to be pulled out from its root. Not it can be done with the simple jab of knife. The tree has grown slowly by consuming all the nutritious elements from the earth. It feeds upon the earth's crust and even rises out of the earth. For years, it keeps absorbing the sunlight, the air, and water. Leaves sprout out of its hide, which looks as if stricken with leprosy. So the word jab is sudden rough blow. सिर्फ एक कट मारने से हम ट्री को किल नहीं कर सकते हैं. This is what Patel wants to say. The word leprous hide means discolored bark. Moving further, so hack and chop. But this alone won't do it. Not so much pain will do it. So, the simple jab of a knife can't kill a tree. It should therefore be hacked and chopped. But this also all alone won't kill a tree. Not so much pain will it do. Use हम कट कर सकेंगे, किल नहीं कर सकेंगे. Further poet says, the bleeding bark will heal and from close to the ground will rise curled green twigs. What he wants to say that जो जहां पे आपने सिंपल जैब ऑफ नाइफ मारा है, जहां पे आपने उसको कट किया है, वहां से उसको जो ब्लीडिंग हो रहा होगा, उसे जो खून निकल रहा होगा, वो कुछ दिनों में हील हो जाएगा. कुछ दिनों में उसको जख्म जो हुआ है उसे मरहम मिल जाएगा. पर वापस से अर्थ के बहुत ही क्लोज से जहां से वो कटा था, एंड फ्रॉम दैट क्लोज टू द ग्राउंड विल अगेन राइज कर्ल्ड ग्रीन ट्विग्स. कर्ल्ड ग्रीन ट्विग्स विल बिगिन टू राइज फ्रॉम नियर द ग्राउंड फ्रॉम वेयर इट हैज बीन चॉप्ड एंड हैक्ड. मिनिएचर बोज विच if unchecked will expand again to the former size. These twigs will again grow into the size of former boughs if they are left unchecked. That means वो वापस से अपनी पुरानी original size में पेड़ आ जाएगा अगर आपने उसे ध्यान नहीं दिया तो. Again it will expand. Further he says, no, the root is to be pulled out of the anchoring earth. Now the meaning of anchoring earth is trees are held securely with the help of roots in the earth. Aaj itne purane jo bade bade ped hain, they are just standing because of the roots which are beneath the earth's crust. So in order to kill the tree, its roots has to be pulled out from the earth, which acts as its एंकर. जैसे कि शिप को भी एंकर के साथ लगाया जाता है, नहीं तो शिप पानी के फ्लो में फ्लो हो जाती है. सो इफ यू वॉन्ट दैट यू वॉन्ट टू किल द ट्री, इट्स रूट्स मस्ट बी अपरूटेड, इट हैज टू बी टाइड. फर्दर ही सेज, इट इज टू बी रोप्ड टाइड and pulled out, snapped out or pulled out entirely. It has to be tied with a rope and pulled out with a powerful snap. जोर से अपन को खींचना पड़ेगा, उसे रूट से, उसे जड़ से निकालना पड़ेगा, तो ही हम कह सकते हैं कि हमने एक ट्री को किल किया है. It has to be pulled out entirely from the earth where it has formed a cave of itself. आज वो उसकी मजबूताई, आज जो वो एकदम अपने आप में फॉर्म डिटरमाइंड खड़ा रहता है, this is only because of the roots. The root of the tree is its real strength. उसकी वाकई में जो ताकत है, that is only lying in its roots. So these were the lines, out from the earth's cave and the strength of the tree exposed, the source white and wet. The root of the tree has its real strength. It is white and wet and is the most sensitive part of the tree. It has been hidden inside the earth for years. The most sensitive, hidden for years inside the earth. This is what the poet wants to explain. Then the matter of scorching and choking in the sun and air, browning, hardening, twisting, withering, and then it is done. So in order to kill the tree, the source has to be pulled out and brought out in the open. It should be left there to scorch and choke. That is the drying up the tree after being uprooted. हमें क्या करना होगा, उसे जड़ से निकालना होगा, उसे उसके रूट से अपरूट करना पड़ेगा और फिर उसे हमें खुले में, नेचुरल एनवायरमेंट में, उसे हवा में, उसे धूप में रख देना होगा, उसे सूख जाने के लिए, for drying it up. It should be left there until it's brown, harden, twists and withers. Only then can the tree be said to be really killed. So G.V. Patel has not taught us how to kill, but he has said that a simple jab of knife cannot kill a tree. So hence a tree is killed. I hope students, you all have understood the message, the moral given by G.V. Patel on the poem Killing a Tree. Now your today's task is, I have displayed you 7 questions on the screen. Write it down in your fair notebook. Complete your work, study well, all the very best, thank you.